Clap for Savannah, everybody.
As we age from adolescence, we tend to realize everything wrong about ourselves and how we can blame our parents for it. This is exactly how Jeanette McCurdy, a child actress most known for her role in the teen show iCarly, felt about her mother. Her mother was emotionally abusive and controlling. The way our parents raise us has a lot to do with who we are, how we change, and it can even determine our chances of success. While McCurdy is known as a very successful woman due to her mother's involvement, her mother is a perfect example of how not to raise your child. In her memoir, I'm Glad My Mom Died, published August 9th of 2022, McCurdy refers to a conversation with her therapist stating that, "Mom was perfect. I know in my gut that I don't believe this, but it's a lot more complicated than that. The way our parents raise us is entirely complicated." So, parenting styles are the ways that the parent reacts to their child through their emotions, behaviors, and attitudes. A child will form their behavior due to the parent's methods of parenting. This comes with levels of demandingness as well as responsiveness. First, we will look at the types of parenting styles. Then we will look at the positive and negative effects of each of them. Then I will explain what the most effective form of parenting is. First is authoritarian parenting. This is where the parent is very strict, has a lot of rules, and on June 23rd of 2017, Helpline, a medical source, states that the style is used due to its belief that the child's behavior and attitude should be shaped by a strict standard of conduct. There is no real explanation for why the parent is so strict, and disobeying the rules will lead to the child facing forms of punishment. Next is permissive parenting, where the parent shows trust, love, and emotional understanding to their child. They are very lenient, where there are no rules or expectations, and thinks of their child as a friend first. For uninvolved parenting, this is where the parent is disconnected from raising their child by any means. They do not care about their child unless something pertaining to the child directly affects them. Now that we have an overview of these three parenting styles, we will look at the positive and negative effects of each of them. For authoritarian parenting, the child will have a good work ethic and sense of responsibility. They will also have less chance of being involved in risky behavior. On September 22nd, 2023, according to an article by Parenting for Brain, which is an informative publication that uses neurological evidence, states that the child will become more resilient due to the harsh discipline that they face. On the other hand, a child of authoritarian parenting will later have poor social skills, low self-esteem, as well as little to no emotional connection with their parents. For permissive parenting, the child will have a good amount of self-esteem in most areas, which is stated based on an article by the International Journal of Environmental Research and Public Health, published on July 2nd of 2019. They will also have a lower chance of risky behavior. And for the negatives, they will likely have very low achievement in life because their parents never set any expectations on them. They will have low self-esteem, they will struggle with self-control and make constant bad decisions. For uninvolved parenting, the child learns self-reliance on their own, and they also have less of a risk of forming a type of PTSD that is most common in the children of authoritarian parenting. The negatives of uninvolved parenting are that the people have bad coping skills as well as communicating and socializing skills. On May 6th of 2023, WOW Parenting, an online course for parents, stated that uninvolved parenting leads to the child to struggle in creating emotional healthy bonds with people in the future. The child will also have likely no emotional connection with their parents. We've looked at the positives and negatives of each parenting style, and now I will explain what the most effective form of parenting is. The best form of parenting is actually a combination of a few of the parenting styles. The best overall is authoritative parenting. This is a combination of permissive parenting and authoritarian parenting. On September 22nd, 2023, Parenting for Brain stated that in the U.S., roughly 46% of parents use authoritative parenting, making it the most popular. This style includes levels of responsiveness and demandingness, where the parent sets pretty fair rules and expectations on their child while also having a strong emotional connection with them. Child raising takes a lot of time and effort. If a parent is not willing to put in the time, then it will result in the child having bad characteristics. And there's no real perfect way for child raising. It just takes trial and error. If one parenting style isn't working out the best for you or your child, then it's best to try other combinations of parenting styles. So we have looked at types of parenting styles, their positive and negative effects, and the most effective form of parenting. We've learned that every child is unique and needs their own set of rules, expectations, and methods for being parent, being raised. At a young age, Jeanette McCurdy was subject to harsh expectations, and as a result of her mother, she has faced struggles in forming relationships, mental illness, eating disorders, and substance abuse. Her mother has an everlasting impact on how McCurdy will live the rest of her life. Parents must start considering how much influence they have on their children, because there are far too many examples, and many being severe, of the eternal effects of inadequate child raising.
You did a good job overall. I feel like I'll start off with the negative things first. You were kind of quiet, but you're also a bit static in terms of like your movement and all. But again, overall, you did a really great job. I really like the examples that you included, and I like how you had you linked the cause and effects of the parenting styles really well. It was very concise, along with your slides, and I personally enjoyed the intro. Also because I've read about her story, so it's something that like I have an interest in, you know. But very good job overall.
I also think your presentation was really good. You had a good like attention grabber because like she's known, you know, so it was like kinda like good to not obviously not good like what happened, but like someone that we know, you know? And your tone was good, but you kind of went quiet, and then you kind of came back up. But overall, your presentation was good.
I feel like you could have used more hand gestures. I love your attention grabber as well. And I liked how you just tied in like different parenting styles, like the positive and negatives, and then that you also had really good, you know, intro and thesis, so, and a conclusion, like how you tied the beginning of her story and use it as an ending as well, which was really great. So, you're welcome.
anyone else that can't read. So did you read that book?
No, I just read summaries of it, but my sister wasn't telling me, like, you should read it.
Oh my god, it's so good. I don't know anything about iCarly. I missed all of that. But it's just trashy and dishy and all sorts of things. So if you ever just need something, I think I read it in a day. It's that kind of book. So are you going to have kids? You're not going to have kids. Why not?
I think it's just really hard on the parent. I don't want to spend, I guess, 18 years raising a child, putting money into it. I just don't have that ability
into it.
It's $300,000.
It's all about the money.
Just have the money. Me too.
Can you reflect on your own upbringing in relationship to what you talked about here?
Yeah. So I think growing up, at a young age, it was mostly authoritative parenting. But as I've grown up, like in my teen years, I guess, my parents have become more permissive, which is strange. But I think the way I grew up really young wasn't good.
Do you have brothers and sisters?
I have, two. One sister, one brother.
Does the parenting style, does it change depending on how many siblings there are?
I think
it
kind of did. With my sister, the oldest, I think she had the toughest time because they were more hard on her. But for my brother, they were very lenient. So I can see the effects of that. It's not very good.
I tend to agree. I mean, I think my parents just gave up when it came to my younger sister because they let her do absolutely anything. Oh, you want to do porn? Sure, whatever you want to do. They just let her go. No, she didn't actually. Well, not that I know of. Anyway, what was I going to ask you? I think that was it. I would just echo, it was a little difficult to hear you.